Hey guys, thanks so much for tuning in to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Kori Ashton here at WebTegrity in San Antonio, Texas. And today's topic is going to be all about search engine optimization and what it means basically to get people to your website and to boost that traffic. And that's why there's a graphic sitting right here that says that. Overall, some people think that SEO is just kind of a magic thing that you do on your website. But that's not the case whatsoever. I've had several emails come through recently asking me about search engine optimization, so that's why we're going to do this video and talk just a little bit about it. Now, overall, there are some basic things that you must do to your website in order to improve the search engine optimization of your actual website itself, all right? There's things behind the scenes in the nerd code that you need to tackle, and there are things on the front side of your website that your visitors will see that you need to be sure that are all in place and correct. And if you don't know what those things are, or if you've questioned and heard that there are different things out there, take a look at this course that I offer here on WebTegrity. I've got a video that you can watch that tells you a little bit more about it. But this is a course, Basics of SEO. It's a 45-minute course I've put together, and I've also given you a coupon discount in the description box below, so you can grab that. Come over and use that. Watch this tutorial. It's going to walk you through and give you an actual worksheet that you can look at your website and work through detail, every single thing that are the major things that are required for Google to love your website. I also have another free resource for you here, and I'll put this link in the description box below. These are all of our blog articles and video tutorials on search engine optimization that will help you better understand some basic things regarding SEO. Overall, though, this is never going to be a one-time fix for your website, and you really need to wrap your head around that. I think this is where a lot of people struggle with search engine optimization. They think, hey, my website's been live for about 6 months or even a year, and I'm still not outranking my competitors. Why am I not on page one yet? When they have all these things maybe even in place and they're still not ranking. Overall, what you need to understand is, again, content is king. You must have good content consistently pouring into your website. You cannot create one website and launch all this amazing content initially and set it out there and expect for Google to continuously fall in love with it over and over again and always rank you higher and higher. You must produce key, incredible content consistently. So that's what WebTegrity has done. Take a look here. If you go back to our homepage on our website, every single week, as y'all well know, we're creating video tutorials for WordPress, and we put them here on our homepage, and you can go through our whole archiving area, and that's exactly what we were talking about here. If you go to tutorials, you can go through our entire archive of all of our WordPress tutorials on a lot of different subjects. This is how I produce fresh content. Now, I know a lot of you are saying, but I'm a small business owner. I don't have time to write content. I'm very busy managing all the other aspects of my business. Here's the problem with that. SEO does not work without content. That's all there is to it. That's the basic bottom line of how search engine optimization works. You can get all these things in a row, which are the elements that I was talking about over here on our class. That's the Basics of SEO class. This will completely walk you through all the different items that are kind of basically a requirement of how Google falls in love with your website and understands what your website is talking about. These are the things you have to have in place. Once you get those in place, the task is not over. It has only just begun. You must pour content consistently into your website. And by consistently, some people say, well, how often is that? It really depends on your industry. So if you're in a fast-paced moving industry like mine, where we're in technology or we're in digital marketing and things are consistently changing, we should minimally blog at least once a week. If you're in an industry that's maybe about crocheting and you want to talk about the different types of yarn that are out there, maybe that doesn't change as frequently. So you could potentially get away with maybe blogging twice a month. That might be something for you to kind of put in your brain. Look at your competitors. See how often they're releasing fresh content. Are they consistently using social media as well? Because that is your next step. You have to be using social media. There is no way around this. Let me say that again. There is no way around this. I have people that tweet to me. I have people that write to me and say, Kori, I really thought that I was doing so well on my website and we were really trying to get things going. And I was using social media for like 6 months straight and boy, I got traffic coming in like crazy. Then it stopped. Why did that happen? And I go look at their social media. It's because they stopped using social media. They got too busy working on their business. They got too busy with all their different orders. And unfortunately, they decided that they were too busy to either write content or run their social media. This is a horrible mistake, and it's made very often. So that's really the way social media works inside of search engine optimization. You write your content, you put the content in your website, and then you go out to your social networks and you let everybody know that that content exists, and you invite them to come read that on your website. You give them the link to your website, you bring that traffic back to your website, inviting everybody with all your different social networks. Does that make sense? You really need to be doing this. And in order to make it something that's manageable, even as a small business, you can use different tools out there. There's Hootsuite that will allow you to basically schedule all your different posts to blast out across all sorts of social medias. So you can come in here on a lazy Sunday afternoon when you've got nothing else going on and schedule all of your posts for the entire month. You can just get inspired one day and write them all out. That way, if there's something major that happens maybe throughout the month and you want to make an extra post, you can just grab your phone while you're at work and make that extra post out on your social media. But when you're too busy working inside the business, these posts will already be blasting out for you because you've come here to Hootsuite and you've scheduled them to post, to publish. There are all sorts of cool tools that you can use like this. WordPress itself has a scheduler inside of it. So if you wanted to blog and write a bunch of blogs and maybe 3 or 4 blogs, then all you do is schedule it to go out once a week. That's all you do, and it's perfect. It looks like you're consistently on top of things when really what you've done is you've taken one great day out of your month and you have stayed focused and you've gotten all these things in line to publish throughout the month. It's really an incredible tool, and it really is the only way you can get search engine optimization to work. You've probably seen this before, that you can get something fast and cheap, and if you want both of those, it's going to be low quality. If you want something fast and high quality, it's probably going to be expensive. If you want something very high quality, but not pay a lot for it, it's probably going to take a long time to get it done. And in no way, shape, or form is there something inexpensive that's super fast and high quality. That's a big fat no. That's exactly the same way it works with search engine optimization. You can try to hire a company to help you do this as well. Even my company offers some search engine optimization resources and services. But here's the key with hiring another company. There is never anybody who's going to understand your products or your services better than you or somebody directly working in your business. I can try to write about an insurance company. I can try to write about jewelry or some other industry out there and try to do my Google researching. But when it comes down to it, truly you or somebody in your business are the best people to write that content. Then, if you would like to then outsource that, once that content is written, send it to somebody like our company or another SEO company out there to help you blast it out and get the word out, that plan could really, really work. Other than that, you're up against the possibility of somebody just writing a bunch of articles and selling them. Let's say that somebody has a bunch of insurance companies and they write one article and they sell it to 10 different insurance companies. It's the exact same article and you wouldn't know that that's happening. But unfortunately, there are rotten SEO companies out there that will do that to you. The other thing that you truly have to understand is if you don't understand fully what's happening on your own website, if you don't understand completely what search engine optimization is, what things must be in place on your current website right now, because even if you're writing a ton of content and using your social media, you could be doing all of this for nothing. Because all of the other things that have to be in place, and that's what this class is about, they're not tended to. Super important that you fully understand what search engine optimization is and what it is not. Because you can really be frustrated realizing that your website is not ranking well and you cannot understand why. You can pay a company thousands and thousands of dollars and they still won't be able to do it because there are key things that must be in place first. I hope this has helped you understand a little bit more about search engine optimization. I know this is a crazy vast subject, so if you have questions or comments, please put them in the thread below here on YouTube. We'll try to comment back as quickly as possible, but know that we get thousands of comments monthly, and it's difficult, but we try our best. If you need help with search engine optimization, I want you to start here first, and the link to this course is in the description box below. Start here first, take this course, use the worksheet that's in this course to help you basically evaluate your own website is what you're gonna do, all right? Evaluate your website, figure out how to get it done correctly. Don't bleed money out there on SEO companies until you have every one of these things in place. Let me know if we can help you further. I hope you're having a great WordPress Wednesday. Bye, y'all.